This is Vifladoo. She is our breeder queen and pretty much our pride and joy. She is the genetic line that Casey has been working on since he started beekeeping for the last 5 years, and she has never been treated once.
Look at that brood pattern. Holy smokes.
She is the queen that is the ground zero of every single queen that we have in our entire operation. So I want to show you guys her today and so you guys can see why we love her so much. And I'm also going to do a mite check today. She's never had one this year. Honestly, I don't even think we did. No, we did not do one on her last year just because we weren't doing any treatments whatsoever. So this is going to be interesting. Yes, Casey has never treated before. He didn't even start using Varroamite treatments until I came into the picture. But really, it wasn't until this year that we started treating. Last year, we stayed completely treatment-free. And we suffered a lot of really bad losses last year in the winter time. So we decided if we were going to ever try to grow and increase our numbers, then we're probably going to have to start treating so that we have some better overwintering success. But one of the things we have been pushing for since really we started beekeeping is trying to find that perfect queen, if there is even one out there, or if she even exists. I think she does. But that perfect queen that is resistant to varroa mites, is able to fend them off on her own without us having to treat them all the time. One that is super productive, resistant to brood diseases, is gentle, makes a very nice cluster of bees to go through winter with, and doesn't use a whole lot of winter stores either. These are all qualities that you kind of need in a queen, especially being in Michigan. So those are the things that he has been focusing on when he's been developing Vifladoo. And so far, she has shown every single one of those traits, except sometimes she can be a little bit feisty. But, you know, you can't have everything. And my favorite way to check for mites is with one of these easy mite checkers. It has that has an extra sleeve on the inside that when you shake it all around, it keeps the bees separated from the mites, and the mites are able to go through those little tiny holes so that you can count them on the bottom. You'll see if you've never seen it before. And then I also use Dawn dish soap. This is something that I learned from actually Bruce's bees a few years back. He started talking about this and I tried it and I am absolutely in love and I've not gone back since. So all this literally is just about a teaspoon of Dawn dish soap, maybe a little bit more. I just squirt it in there and look at the color. And hot water. It can be any type of water, cold, hot. I just usually do hot water. I find that works the best. Instead of using alcohol, this is actually supposed to give you a more accurate result when you are counting for varroa. They say that you'll get a couple more varroa mites off when you're using Dawn dish soap versus when you're using an alcohol wash instead. But first, let's just see how she's doing before we start doing that. Let's look at how her brood pattern's looking this time of year. See how much honey she has. I do see that she does have a super on top right here with a queen excluder, so they're probably working on some honey. Right now, they don't even realize I'm here. It's not until you start going into their hive. Sometimes they can get a little bit feisty, but maybe we'll see. It just depends on the day. She can get a little moody sometimes. Springtime, though, she is so nice. She could care less. All she cares about is all the honey that she's bringing in. Ooh, she's got this propolized down. Oh my gosh, I can't even get it open. Oh, come on. And I'm not using any smoke either. We tend to not like to use smoke. Unless we're like doing something big that day where we're just going to be like doing a bunch of splits. There's going to be a bunch of bees everywhere. Then we'll do that so we can move fast. But we tend to try to stick to no smoke. Okay, she is doing great up in the super, though. Oh, yeah, see? They're like, ooh, somebody's in my hive. Maybe it would be good to use smoke so they don't start going crazy on me. Actually, yeah, let's not be crazy. Let me go get smoke. I'll be right back. All right. That's better. It's also partially because they have honey right now. Bees always get feisty once they get honey. Alright, so let's see how much honey they have up here. We have been, like I mentioned, been going through a little bit of a dearth this year. Oh gosh, dang it. They're propolizing this down so bad that I'm ripping apart frames. So we haven't had as much coming in this year as we normally would. We completely skipped black locust. I didn't even see basswood. And then we don't have sourwood up here, so, which kind of stinks, but we do have a lot of purple loosestrife right now that I've been seeing in bloom. I don't know if there's any in the area for this hive in particular. Gosh, they got these frames really, really propolized. Oh, that's kind of heavy. Oh yeah, they got that full of honey. It's like they got this whole top box full of honey. Not quite capped yet. They're still working on it. All right, so let's just go ahead and hurry up and go to where the brood is. This is going to be a heavy frame when I lift it off. Okay, where am I going to put this is the question. Ooh. Yeah, one of my frames came apart. Oh gosh. Yeah, you can tell she hasn't been opened in a while. And I'm trying to keep that queen excluder right there. Okay. Oh gosh, yeah, they have honey up here too even. Yeah, that is really good to see. They have a bunch of honey up here, so that is almost like their second box of honey. That's gonna be nice. They already have all of this for winter time, so we don't have to worry about it. We're pretty much like really hands off with her. We just steal some of her larvae for grafting, but other than that, we just let her keep doing her thing. We haven't fed her at all, haven't treated her at all, haven't even put pollen patties on her this year. So actually we might have put one on at the beginning of the year. We had a little bit of a dearth, so I think we did do that. But other than that, very hands-off with her. I told Casey I was going through Viplidoo, and he instantly was like, be very careful with her. Yes, love. Of course. Like I said, this queen is his pride and joy. So I don't blame him. He's been working on her for a long time. Oh, okay. I don't know how I'm gonna get any of these frames out. Because they are just little propolis makers. So, we have a lot of her daughters in all of these nukes that we have across the yard you guys have been seeing. She also was in all of our nukes this year that many of you guys were able to purchase and take home to start for yourself. We got a nice arc of honey, and then she has some eggs right down there, and then another nice arc of honey with some beautiful, beautiful cappings. The one thing I love about Viplidoo as well, amongst all of the other many things, is her cappings have like an ombre color, and I don't know why or what that is, but it's really cool. We've always wondered if she has part Russian genetics in her, because we have seen a couple of our other beekeeping friends their hives that are 100% purebred Russians, and they look very similar in how their cappings are, how they arrange their hive, that kind of stuff. Uh-oh, she is thinking about swarming. Off till Casey. This is his baby, so I don't move things around. I just am showing you guys. So yeah, I'll let him know that he's gonna have to do something with her so we don't end up losing her. He hasn't grafted in a while either. We've had some unexpected life happenings in terms of his health and whatnot, so he hasn't been able to do that, but that's okay. So we have a frame fully laid up of eggs. Oh, hey. What's up?
How's she doing?
Good. She has swarm cups on this frame.
Get them down.
What do you want to do to her other than that?
What do I need to do?
Sorry. Whatever you want to do, love, with her. She's your baby. So, I don't know if you guys can see them, but this is the other thing that I like about Vipladu. Every single one of her daughters comes back laying like this. Just sheets on sheets of eggs. That's how we know it's her, honestly. He did a really good job stabilizing her genetic. So, every single one of her daughters come back exactly like her, which is something that you do want to see in your bees, because there's a lot of queens that we've bred from and they don't always come back looking like the mother did, like the mother was. Now, it could also be too that it is from our area and whatever local bee she's breeding with is bringing in that other half of genetics that make them to be the way they are. But when they come back, they are on a freaking mission. I think honestly sometimes that she may be laying more eggs than the hive can manage, but they always manage it very well. So she knows what she's doing, but one of the many things I love about her. Woo! Oh yeah, she's wanting to swarm. She's got quite a few swarm cups down here, but she has not been split. Casey has held her back from swarming all year. She's an older queen, so it's actually really impressive that she hasn't swarmed yet. He also tries to breed for bees that don't just swarm at the drop of a hat. Of course, they're going to swarm if they're a healthy colony. That's normal. That's just how they disperse their genetics everywhere. But there's also some bees, I don't know if you've ever seen those, where they just seem to swarm even when it's not time to swarm. Just no matter what they do, they don't even build the whole hive. It's just swarm, swarm, swarm. So yeah, there's so many bees in there, you can't really see the brood pattern. But yeah, she's looking good. Oh, and he said to tear them down. Okay. I will tear them down then. I'll have to pull out that other frame and tear those down too. Oh. Uh-oh. Might be about out of smoke. I'm not good with lighting smokers with a hand lighter. I usually use a stick lighter, but I could not find my stick lighter, so I had to use a hand lighter. Ooh. And we have another frame of honey and eggs. She's looking good. She's wanting to swarm, though. She has a ton of cups. Are you afraid I'm gonna like do something or something?
No.
Oh, okay.
I can't get the
clothes. Oh, I know. He doesn't have a suit on. He's standing right behind the camera right now. You guys can't see him, but he decided to come out here and join. Okay, so I'm not gonna pull it out because there's not really any point in pulling it out. But then these last two frames over here against the wall are just straight capped honey from what I saw. And I see the same thing on this other side of the hive against the wall, just straight capped honey, which is good. Yeah, they're getting a little feisty. Do you want to do me a favor? You know how bad I am at lighting a smoker with a hand lighter? Do you want to relight it? Thank you. Oh, but don't you like the sting of these, of her? I thought it was this hive, the one that you said you loved the sting. Because they help his joints.
They're not stingy right now.
Just buzzy? Oh, it's because they have honey. I will say, in terms of swarming, they only have one with an egg and then one with like a little larva that probably just hatched out yesterday. So they're not like going crazy trying to make swarm cells or nothing like that. Ooh. But yeah, they have a lot of honey in here. Honestly, all they need is this box right here and they'll have plenty. Because this is also the queen that he did experiments on the last couple years. He did stress tests on them, meaning he originally had them in a 5/5 nuc. And, well, actually, do you want to explain it? Because it's been a minute since we've actually talked about some of the things he used to do. There's a mic inside that box. Just pick up the second one and put it on. All right, go ahead and say something.
Hello?
Yep. Okay. So, do you want to explain what you did with the stress test? What that was?
I just picked hard conditions for them. I decided I wanted to see, I picked a goal for each one, and it didn't have to be a reasonable goal. It just had to be able to put them in. They'd either survive it or die. So I spent a lot of the years just worrying about stress testing. I wanted to see if they could do certain things, if they couldn't do certain things. And it didn't bother me if they lived or died.
What was the one that you did with the food? You had them in a 5/5, I thought you said, and
Yeah,
then.
no, I had them in a single five. Her original line survived in a single five stack on this table back over here where I have the nuke. There's three of them, and they were all given just 5 frames of straight capped honey. She was thrown in there with them. I dissembled her hive, made splits out of all of it, and then gave her as many bees that would fit in there with her. And then I let her winter there like that, along with two other ones, and she survived it, as where the other two ones didn't. That was that whole frugality test I was telling you about in the beginning of everything. But I'm learning that the YouTube comments are absolutely wonderful in the sense that you can have a guy be like, "Well, I selected for the left hair on the right leg to be blue," and they'll be like, "That's exactly what you can select for." And if I say something along the lines of, "I selected through a trial of grafting daughter after daughter to see which ones had a higher rate of coming back from their mating flights, so I started testing for mating flights and which ones did better and which ones came back based off just learning to graft in the early days and doing a lot of grafting off the same queens over and over again, running them through boxes." But everybody, I don't know. I'm one of those people that I think that her, the channel's comments have gotten a little, non-productive. You guys make us not want to have to talk to you. Or at least me. So, have fun.
Wow, look at that. This is what I love about her. Her brood pattern is absolutely beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. So, for our mite test, we're going to take bees from a frame with open larvae. And the reason for that is those are the bees that are going to be caring for the brood. So, those are the ones that are usually going to have more mites on them because the mites hop out of the brood onto the bees, or vice versa, off the bees into the brood. And that's also where you're going to have your nurse bees so that if there was any mites living on them when they came out, because nurse bees are. I think that's like what, the second or third stage that they go through. First, when they emerge, they're like cleaners, and then after that, they turn into nurse bees. I think it's the second stage. Okay, so there's one swarm cell right there. Got a little bit of larva right here. I think this next frame looks like it's gonna be a larva frame. Yeah, they're gonna be really mad at me when I kill some of them. They're really gonna get angry then. They're gonna start attacking. Now they're not like jumping on you, they're just swarming around. If you guys have ever seen, had a hive like that, then you know what I mean. But there's some hives that they'll just jump right on you and just try to get inside your suit. She's not one of those, which is nice. She has a lot of capped brood frames in here right now, which means she is gonna be booming if we don't do something with her to cut her back. I have not seen her, Viplidoo, the queen, at all yet, but that's okay. We don't need to find the queen. Huh? She's invisible? Yeah, no, she is. Her coloring makes her very hard to find. Okay, so they have more capped brood than they do open larva. Just a heads up, love. They have more capped brood than larva. They only have like two egg frames and like one larva frame, and they have like at least 9 capped brood frames, probably more. I know, but she's about to be booming. More so than she already is. Alright, so we're going to use this frame right here. I was trying to find the best one, but she has so much capped brood right now. This one has quite a bit of larva in it, so we'll use this one. Always double and triple check that there's no queen on here. Honestly, if she's getting kind of old, what's your plans for her in terms of next generation? You already have her daughters. I know. But you might as well. Well, she's just here to live out her life, is what he said. Whatever she does and I can't repeat what you just said. You have to have a mic. They won't be able to hear you. We're still learning this whole mic system thing. I wanted you guys to be able to hear us better, so I finally found some that worked really well.
Am I connected?
Say something again.
Am I connected?
Yep.
Whatever she wants to do, whatever she wants to be, whatever she wants to do with her hive, she is free to do those things with it because she has made it past her years. So I am just letting her be a bee. She's gone through her experiences, if you will. I feel like after so many years, her daughters can take her place and she can just live life. Well, guys.
All right, so I have this Dawn dish soap. I just pour it in there about halfway. And I like to get it out and ready because it moves pretty fast. Now, I guess it's a good thing it has a lid. So I usually have a half cup scooper, but I forgot to bring one because it's been a while since I've done a mite check. So I'm just going to use this, and then I also use, this is why I like telescoping lovers. I like telescoping covers because I'm going to hit the frame into this. All the bees will fall off. Any ones that fly away, you don't want. And then I'll just shake it so they get down to this bottom corner, scoop them out, put them in there. And triple check one more time. There's no queen. This is going to be interesting. I'm kind of nervous to see what her mite load's at, because like I said, she hasn't been treated ever. Alright, that looks to be about half a cup. Ah! I never like doing this because of all the bees that you kill, but it's alright. This is for the sake of science and our whole operation. Alright, so far I think I see 4. This usually takes a little bit though. Let's see. Oh nope, that's wax. So I see 2, 3. Alright, we'll get this hive put back together first. before we see what the official number is. Sometimes they fall off after a couple minutes, so it takes just a little bit. Oh, where did I put? Okay, cool. Oh yeah, they're really not happy now. Sorry. I know. But it will be okay, I promise.
Oh, they finally got that frame filled out.
Oh, this was one they built out?
Yeah, that white one was, they had a couple in there that weren't filled out yet.
Okay. Oh, is he under drop frames this year? Oh my gosh! Oh! Oh, that's heavy. Okay, one more box.
How are they doing on their honey?
Oh, good. One of the frames is broken, though, unfortunately.
If you take it out, I might be able to fix it.
Take it out, you said?
Take it out, and I might be able to fix it.
Okay, I can try to take it out. But yeah, they're doing good. It's not capped yet, but they have everything. They have honey in every single one of these frames.
Really?
Yeah, so they're working on it. I think the outside ones are the only ones that kind of look like they don't have anything in it. Gosh, I hate when this happens. Oh my gosh. Come on. See how hard I'm struggling, Liv? Are you sure you want this frame out?
Yeah, otherwise they're going to make a whole mess in there.
There we go. Okay. Yeah, see? Nobody likes when that happens. Top bar came off. Here you go.
There it is. There's coming up there. Can I borrow your head cool for a second?
Yeah, here you go. Alright, well, I'm waiting for him to fix that. Yeah, they don't look too bad. They're looking strong. All right, so I see 1, 2, 3, 4. That looks like a piece of leaf. Yeah, that's a piece of leaf. Here, I'll show you guys. Let me zoom in a little bit. Okay, so what I'm looking at, you see those little orange dots? So 1, 2, 3 right there. That dark one right there doesn't look like a mite. It looks like a piece of leaf. So we have 3. There was a fourth one though. Where'd it go? Right there. So we have 1 right there, and then we have 3 right there. So that's 4. That's actually really good. 4 is not bad at all. Now, she does have a lot of capped brood, though, so keep that in mind. Possibly her mite levels could be higher, but we're going to check again in a month just to kind of get a baseline of where we see that she's at. We're not going to treat her at all this winter either, so she's going to go back through winter without any treatments and see if she makes it through. And just like Casey said, if she decides she wants to swarm, she's going to get to swarm. We're not going to stop her. She just gets to be a bee now. She's already done us a great service. And how many, oh my gosh, we've gotten so many daughters off of her. It's insane. So many. Yeah, see, now they're just more worried about getting in the hive. They don't really care about you getting up there.
Yep. I mean, I think when you get to like your fourth year old or something like that, you get to like go into the retirement home. So she's in her retirement beekeeping stage.
I like that. It's fair. She's lived a great life. She's provided a lot. She's done a lot for us, more than we could ever ask for. So definitely not going to ask for anything more from her. Now she just gets to do her thing.
Whatever makes her happy.
All right, so one last check. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have 1 up there and then the 3 right there. I don't see any else. 4 is great. I believe, I don't remember the math. Here, let me pause and do the math real fast. All right, so generally you want to make sure your mite level is below 3%, so that would be 10 mites in a wash. And the reason it's 10 mites is because in theory you're going to be taking around 300 bees with half a cup of bees. So we are looking at only a 1.3% mite load, which is not bad at all. But like I said, keep in mind all of that capped brood, that's going to be housing a lot of mites. So we're going to see it again in a month once a lot of this is emerged and out and about and see if it's still that high. But I think that's pretty much all I really wanted to show you guys today. Was there anything else you wanted to say about Viplidoo or anything else?
Let's see how our daughters are looking.
Okay. All right, well, that is it from us today. Hope you guys had a good time just taking a peek into our bee yard and our life for however long this video will be. But I hope you guys are doing great, and I hope you guys are getting ready for winter time because it's going to be here before we know it. Unfortunately, life as a beekeeper, we're always thinking about winter around this time of year. Crazy, right? Because most other people are like in the lake thinking about summertime because it's still only July. But anyways, all right, see you guys soon. Don't quit and be fit.